One-on-One with Jane Mitchell.
Because, I mean, everybody knew Adrian was going to go up eventually. Nobody really knew if I was going to go up.
After Adrian's game in San Diego that afternoon, his wife Betsy, who already knew, urges him to call Edgar.
For a second, I was like, he might get called up. But then for a second, I was like, he might have been traded. I'm not a guy that really shows emotion, but inside I feel it, and I just really felt it.
Edgar flies to Chicago to join the team.
And I remember the first thing I walked out into Wrigley Field, I'm like, whoa. But I'm like, it looks bigger on TV. And then that's what I told Adrian. But then you got to go and touch the ivy in the outfield. When I put the Padre uniform, I've been a Padre fan. And now playing for the Padres is pretty exciting.
So Edgar and Adrian are the sixth set of brothers to play for the Padres.
Then Edgar finally has his moment, put in at third, then faces Carlos Zambrano, one of the best pitchers in baseball.
I think my legs were a little wobbly, but I wasn't too nervous. I was a little focused. I was focused, and I wanted to just put a good swing at the ball.
And Edgar has a base hit in his first major league plate appearance.
The only thing that kept me from jumping up and down was the fact that we were losing by 7 runs after they drove in the run. So kind of hard to jump up around down the dugout when you're losing.
So Edgar's hit safely in each of his two appearances here.
This magical Monday, the first of many firsts, and a long time coming. Edgar had been on the St. Louis Cardinals AAA team, but after the 2007 season and a free agent, he signed a minor league contract with the Padres, which included being a non-roster invitee to big league camp to compete for a bench job.
I couldn't refuse it and be with my brother too. I mean, you can't beat that chance.
Let's